Well, hi guys. Today I'll be building a PC because well, that's what I do. Not what I do. Actually, I'm a software engineer, but I also know how to assemble a PC because I think that's not a key part of our work, but it's always interesting to know how to assemble a PC. I started doing overclocking for some years now, but so I became interested in assembling my own computer. But some time now I have stopped doing this because I started using Macintosh and Apple computers. Maybe because they are more reliable. Well, let the flame war begin. I'm not. This is just my opinion. But they are expensive. They are maybe too expensive for what they provide. I don't think so. In my opinion, I think that Apple computers, especially the laptops, are quite interesting. They are very good work tools. And well, let's stop about the rambling with the Apple computers, shall we? So, let's get on to business. What I will show you is the solution that a lot of people have been adopting recently. That is building a Hackintosh. What's a Hackintosh? Well, it's basically a computer that you build using standard PC hardware that runs Mac OS X. So you have the best of both worlds, the expandability, speed, because you can buy much faster components from the same money or even less, and provided you know how to tweak the operating system to work with those PC parts. Back in the day when I started building Hackintoshes, it was not pretty. It was very complicated. My first computer was my first Hackintosh was a AMD 64 machine with a graphics card. It was the 600, 6800, I think, 6800 by NVIDIA. And from those times, people have the community has been growing a lot in the Hackintosh community, and there are a lot of tools, a lot of great tools that make building a Hackintosh a breeze. It's very, very easy. And I can say from personal experience that I've been using Hackintoshes for well, a lot of time for recreational uses always, but I can say I use a Mac Pro at work, and I can say that my Hackintosh had zero kernel panics, and my Mac Pro already had one kernel panic. So, in terms of reliability, the Hackintosh is in the lead. So it's funny, but that's how it goes. So I'll be building today. I'll be building a Hackintosh server. For the goal of this machine is to serve virtual machines, so it will have a lot of RAM and a quad-core processor, but it won't have any graphics card because it's not needed for serving virtual machines. So after these considerations are done, let's get on with it, shall we?